fill thy hearts to lie to the Holy Ghost, and to keep her apart of the presence of the Lamb. While it remained, was it not thine? And after it was so, was it not thy own power? Why hast thou conceived this thing in thy heart? Thou hast not lied unto men, but unto God. And Ananias, hearing this word, fell down and died. This was what our Lord said about using our mouths to lie against the Holy Ghost. And whosoever shall speak a word against the Son of Man, it shall be forgiven him. But unto him that blasphemes against the Holy Ghost, it shall not be forgiven. Luke 12:10. Whenever we make pledges inside the church, we are entering into covenant with the Holy Ghost and not with the members of the church. Hence, it is advisable to redeem such a pledge and not defy your word. It is better not to make pledges or promises to God or your fellow Christian brothers just to make God feel happy, or your Christian brother, when you do not have the genuine desire or intention to fulfill your promise. God used word to create the world and all living things. And if you know the right word and how to use it, we shall obtain favor from God. If you remember the story of Anna, she was barren, but she never gave up hope. And with words of supplication, she brought all her burden to Christ, who is the Word. And she vowed a vow and said, O Lord of hosts, if thou will indeed look on the affliction of thy handmaid, and remember me, and not forget thy handmaid, but will give unto thy handmaid a man child, then I will give him unto the Lord all the days of his life, and there shall no razor come upon his head. Samuel 1:11. This is total commitment. And why will God not answer such prayers? And her prayer was answered immediately by God, speaking through Prophet Eli in verses 17 and 18. Then Eli answered and said, go in peace. And the God of Israel grant thee thy petition that thou hast asked of him. And she said, let thy handmaid find grace in thy sight, O Lord. So the woman went her way and did eat, and her countenance was no more sad. Amen. Samuel grew up to become one of the greatest prophets in Israel.
Amen.
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 Today, we are once again asking ourselves, how many pledges, how many promises we have made to God? How many promises we have made to God's servants? How many promises we have made to our own fellow brethren? If our requests are granted, we shall do this and we shall do that. We have to start searching our individual conscience and make amends in this new year. So that we shall not remain a debtor forever, as it blocks all other graces coming from God.
Glory.
Amen. We have all had our shares of these bogus pledges, of these bogus assurances and unpleasant experiences from people in our lives, who because of what they stand to gain from our kindness and generosity, they promise heaven and earth, but no sooner they get what they want from us, they disappear without looking back. If we were to have all these parasite pledges present here today, this church will be filled to capacity. But one thing I know is that God will bring his own dedicated and committed believers.
Amen.
Who are ready to serve the Lord and work with us.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes I just wonder why we never get tired doing good and showing hospitality without really depending or expecting a reciprocal gesture. Then I remember God's word in Galatians 6, verse 9. He said, let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up.
Amen.
So do not throw away your confidence. It will be richly rewarded. You need to persevere, so that when you have done the will of God, you will receive what he has promised. For in just a very little while, He who is coming will come and will not delay. But my righteous one will live by faith. And if he shrinks back, I will not be pleased with him. But we are not of those who shrink back and are destroyed, but of those who believe and are saved. Amen.
Amen.
God sent Samuel to the house of Jesse to anoint the chosen one of the seven sons of Jesse. And when the sons of Jesse were presenting themselves one by one before Samuel, God saw the heart of Samuel, that the picture of God's choice would also look like Saul, muscular, tall, and handsome. But God cautioned Samuel in these words. But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth. For man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart.
Amen.
We have had so many unfortunate, avoidable, bitter experiences in this church over the years with regrettable consequences, either due to our wrong choices, our obstinacy, leading to wrong and irrational actions, or counting on the advice of those we feel we could put all our trust, but only being disappointed. And this was why God told Samuel, for the Lord seeth not as man seeth. For man looketh on the outward appearance, human judgment, and consideration, which are many times flouted with deception. But the Lord looketh on the heart.
Amen.
We thank God, however.
Amen.
For letting us go through this frustrating transformation in the history of our church, so that when God now places us where he has destined for us, we shall know how to manage God's glory and sustain it without yielding to any external influences, but to put our absolute trust in Christ Jesus to lead us in this church. Who can God not use? Have you ruled out yourself that you are not good for the Lord? Or are you believing what your family, your friends, and boss are telling you, that you are useless and a failure? Satan is a liar. Do not believe them, because what you are going through or what you are going to become in life has already been predestined even before you were conceived in your mother's womb. Hence, David is the last born, the deprived of the family, who has been regarded as the surplus of the children, only used to starve, the rest, and tend to their father's sheep in the wilderness. As an outcast was remembered by God, David was reluctantly summoned before Samuel, and God said the word again, and he sent and brought him. Now he was ruddy, with all of a beautiful countenance, and goodly to look at. And the Lord said, arise, anoint him, for this is he. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose and went to Ramah. I decree today, in the presence of your enemies and all those who have concluded that you can never make it in life, I decree today that God will anoint your head, and your cup shall overflow with blessing in Jesus' name. Yea. Though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you will fear no evil. For the Lord will be with you. His rod and his staff will comfort you. The Lord will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. He will anoint your head with oil. Your cup shall run over. Your blessing shall overflow. And surely goodness and mercy shall always follow you all the days of your life. And you will always dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Hallelujah.
And so, David was full of the power of the Holy Spirit. And his father sent him to the battlefield to take food to his brothers. David was brought before the king Saul concerning the confrontation they were having with the boastful, uncircumcised Philistine, the giant called Goliath, who had been challenging the armies of God's people. Saul looked at David, young and handsome, and said, like most of us will say, and Saul said to David, "Thou art not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for thou art but a youth, and he is a man of war from his youth." While man looks at the countenance, God looks at the heart.
Amen.
And David answered, "As one filled with the Holy Spirit." I will once again read from 1 Samuel 17:34-37. And David said unto Samuel, "Thy servant kept his father's sheep, and there came a lion and a bear, and took a lamb out of the flock, and I went out after him and smote him and delivered it out of his mouth. And when he arose against me, I caught him by his beard and smote him and slew him. Thy servant slew both the lion and the bear, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be as one of them,
Amen.
Seeing he had defied the armies of the living God."
Oh, yes.
David said, "Moreover, the Lord that delivered me out of the paw of the lion and out of the paw of the bear, he will deliver me out of the hand of this Philistine."
Amen.
And so said unto David, "Go, and the Lord be with thee." What a statement of total confidence in the Lord. Praise God.
Amen.
We pray the Almighty God to open our hearts and reveal to us his greatness and unlimited support that he is ever ready to keep us in times of our need.
Amen.
If only we recognize him and believe he could and would do it for us.
Amen.
Oh my God. It is good to read the Holy Bible and beg God to reveal the truth of the world.
Yes.
My fellow brother Christians, these are undisputable testimonies that Jesus is sharing with us today. And what excuse can we then have from today that we will not still serve the Lord in spirit and in truth? My humble prayer today is that all giants in your life challenging you and frustrating you or intimidating you that you cannot progress, God will send his Holy Ghost fire to consume them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The wall of Jericho in your life will be flattened down wherever you call on the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because our Lord and Master have overcome the world.
Amen.
Amen. At this beginning of another new year of our journey, in joint fellowship with Christ, let all of us be of sober reflection, asking God to forgive us and cleanse us of all our iniquities, and remove all traces of tribulations, doubts, and hypocrisy from our life. We should love one another, get nearer to our God, and let us make our church a sanctuary with open hands to welcome anybody, and not a closed shop, and it shall be well with us all. Remember what the Lord said in Matthew 28:10-11, "Come to me, all who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls." We must never, through our action, through our words, try to shut the gates of the sanctuary on the faces of our fellow Christian brethren, so that we too may have the confidence to approach the throne of grace for mercy at the time of our own need. If Apostle John had made bold to reveal to us who is the Word, as in John 1:1-5, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, And the Word was God. What does this tell us? It simply means we have Christ in us. We speak through Christ as we live in Him and Him in us, knowing this fact today. Is it not time we start changing from our old ways in this satanic corrupted world and follow the path of salvation? In Christ, where unconditional love abounds. We should start today to use our words to uplift and to raise our fellow human beings, members of our church, members of our family, friends, and those in need of that moral support from us. Do not use your words to demoralize others. Do not use your words to discredit your fellow Christian brethren or human beings. If you cannot help them, do not murder them with your words.
Amen.
It is better to be silent rather than pronouncing judgment on yourselves.